The stakes are high for the Bortianor Ngleshie Amanfro constituency in the South Municipality of the Greater Accra Region. The incumbent Member of Parliament, Bright Kuju Domechi, says the creation of the constituency in 2012 faced a stiff contest from the NPP and PPP. My colleague Stephen Anti has been profiling Bortianor Ngleshie Amanfro constituency. Here is the first of two stories from there.
Bortianor Ngleshie Amanfro is one of 45 new constituencies created in 2012, carved out of the Wager Bawe constituency. It lies on the boundaries of the beautiful Wager Hills and stretches to the coastline of Aplaku all the way to Kokrobite. There are seven electoral areas in this constituency: Galilea, Tuba, Amanfro, Bortianor, Akwasa, Kokrobite, and Oshie.
This is only one side of the Bortianor Ngleshie Amanfro constituency. Now, over the past 4 years, this community has been booming. It has become popular for the springing up of beach resorts, and expensive homes are all being constructed here. But that's just the surface of it. When we go down, the community is faced with a lot of challenges, including sanitation, water challenges, and a host of them. Healthcare, the road which runs through this community is partly complete, with the part which is uncompleted, dusty, totally dusty, and the residents are engulfed on a daily basis with dust.
The challenges of Bortianor are enormous. People here are predominantly fisher folks. Some resort to other forms of manual labor to irk a living from the fishing industry. A few are small-scale farmers, and the women, predominantly fishmongers, stay at home to care for the children. The area lack an effective drainage system, and sanitation plus inadequate healthcare infrastructure make people here bitter at the slow pace of development. The sentiments of the elders reflect those of residents.
Tax collection has been regular in this community, and the people pay their taxes, but we don't see anything relevant that our taxes have been used for. Markets, schools, community centers, we lack all these things.
My opinion, we are appealing to the government to come to our aid in terms of some of the social amenities like the schools, our water problem, and the market in the community. Because when it comes in terms of election, we put our maximum effort and we couldn't achieve anything, so we are appealing to the government to come to our aid. I think that's all.
Gankrowa Unupa Bortianor ni waye ko ni shomoye.
Bortianor is an old town with an arable land with a stream which flows down to the sea, but residents have not taken good care of the stream, constructing structures in the waterway and blocking its flow into the sea. We have complained to the South Municipal Assembly to remove these structures from the waterway, but to no avail.
The assemblyman for Bortianor re-echoes these sentiments.
We are facing a lot of challenges in the community, especially when it comes to water. You know, we just close to Densu, and then we always hear of sending water to Madina and its surroundings. So we hope if, because we close to Densu, at least we should have that amenity just for our sake. I've talked to the DC and he's assured me of having some container that will take our debris. But initially it was very bad. For now we have a task force at hand that will check the defecation of people going to.
So the task force is still there?
Yes, they are.
Still working?
They are.
What
yes.
are they doing? They are.
They go at the beaches to check on those who come around to defecate, and now it's better than before.
He can only appeal to the Kasauth Municipal Assembly to expedite development projects here.
On the weekend, you saw roads be constructed, and there's a portion that has been left out. I'll be grateful if the government can come in so that those who will be affected on that portion of land will be compensated and that the road can go on.
Their roads are horrible. Part under construction, part completed, and the outcome is very shoddy. Waste collection, sanitation at the beaches, these remain key problems facing the coastal communities in this constituency.
I'm standing right in the middle of one of the communities in Bortianor, Ngleshie, Amanfro, called Chokome. The basic problem facing these people here is sanitation. We are told that the main refuse dump near to the main road of this town was closed by the Kasauth Municipal Assembly, and every dumping has been directed here, which is close to the sea. There is a high probability that the fish you consume if you live in Bortianor, Bawe, Malam might be coming from here, where the fish competes with the filth. I have one of the community leaders joining us for a chat. He will walk us through some of their expectation, what this community expects of the people they elect into office, and what the considerations will be come November when they go to the polls.
You know, this our community is a fishing community, you know, and because we don't have any place to dump our refuse, and we try from the beginning, our women, when it is time, the sea must come rough, and it will disturb all of those who near the river or the sea. So they started this one as deferring, like sea defense, so that if the sea started, want to disturb them, it will defend them. But later on, we see that it will worry us rather, not to help us. And we decide that we must, as unit committee member, and including assemblyman and opinion leaders in the community, we are now coming together, and I think at least let the assembly, the municipal, to know that this is our problem. At least if they can give us a refuse container, dustbin, so that anytime we can dump our refuse inside, when it full up, they will come and take it back for us. I think that will help it, it can help us a lot.
Is it possible that people will say that we're tired of this situation and we will no longer vote for you?
No, when you hear people are saying we are no more going to vote, so and so, so many comments, it doesn't concern what we are looking for here right now. People, when you hear people saying that, they say our women say they are fishmongers. They need government to help them at least small money, their capital, to start their job. If you hear them saying something like that, we are not going to vote, we are not going to, because of their financial problem. But this one that we are talking about right now is because we don't have any place to dump our refuse, as I said from the beginning.
Expectations are high. The odds of retaining the seat are pretty tight for the NDC, with analysts predicting the incumbent MP, Bright Kojo Demoji, might have a difficult task ahead. He won his party's primaries against broadcaster Gideon Ayikwe, and now has been accused of not attending to the developmental needs of especially the coastal communities of Bortianor, Aplaku, Oshie, and Kokorobite. In 2012, the incumbent MP secured 23,014 votes to win the seat, with just about 300 votes more than the MPP contender Ajete Labi, who secured 22,826. Whilst Evans Ni Jabong Mensah of the DPP had 1,959, representing 4%. Frankie Jukum of the PPP polled 984, representing 2.01%. And Ali Hununu of the NDP had 192, representing 0.39%. Incidentally, Ajete Labi, who was disqualified from contesting the MPP primaries, is now contesting on the ticket of the Progressive People's Party, PPP. The MPP parliamentary candidate here is Alhaji Habib Saad, who is determined to unseat Bright Demoji. But the MPP's own divided front, with Reverend Ajete Labi, who secured over 22,000 votes in the 2012 elections, might pose a threat to the ambitions of Alhaji Saad, who many see as a new entrant into politics. The challenges of Ngleshie Amanfro are not any different from those of Bortianor.